Once again, it has been a pleasure to bring you some of the temple of hip hop.
You had, well, my man Footmaster Flex, my man Kid Capri, and you know.
Nothing flies out in the business, but Billy, what do you do to max your relax?
Well, Freddie, I usually like to spend a quiet evening at home with a few friends and Colt 45.
On the corner, just a waste of time. And when I realized it was the king of the rhyme, I got on the microphone. And what
hey, yo, hey, yo.
All right, you already know what it is. It's Quan the Bomb. We right back at it. Yo, today, we saluting the legend, my man, Record Town Roger, a.k.a. Roger from Record Town. We call my boy the hip-hop historian. You know what I'm saying? Mr. Info, Minister of Information for the 585. You know what I'm saying? So we can go in here, see what my man talking about, surprise him with this war. Quan the Bomb, Hood Legends. Let's go. Big shout out to Coach Bill Parcells. We here.
Kiss FM, it's the Saturday Night Mass Mix Dance Party. I'm Jerry Young, and on the turntables tonight we have cool DJ Red Alert. Oh yes, about 24 minutes past the hour of 11. Clear and comfortable for the overnight with the low nearing 70 degrees. Later today, sunny and pleasant with highs in the mid-80s. As for Monday, sunny and warm with highs in the 80s. Right now we have 78 degrees in Central Park.
Yo, you move.
What's up, what's up?
Raj.
Oh,
my boy,
no.
Raj from Record Town. We had to pull him from this show. We didn't want to bum rush the show and make it look like we was taking over the show today. You know what I'm saying?
No doubt.
But it's my boy, Raj.
This dude.
You see what it say? In honor of Record Town, Raj.
Oh, man.
Hip-hop historian.
Yo.
You know what I'm saying? It's his birthday. We had to get him
no
on
doubt.
His birthday. You
no
know
doubt.
What I'm saying?
No,
we
want to
present
that.
This man because he's a legend. If you don't know Raj, he's going to let you know about him from Record Town. It's one of my mans go way back. That's a real story. I always got to tell somebody about somebody.
Oh, no.
Raj was one of my main competitions in mixtapes because he was getting exclusives and pressing them up. He was like Q and Juice, 25 pop.
He said Q.
80-minute CD, 80-minute tapes.
No doubt.
80-minute tapes, all exclusive. I'm like, they coming in, he getting the bread. I said, I got to step my bread up and get this nigga. This nigga was killing it. So we got to give him a shout because little, for real. He's a mixtape DJ. He wasn't on turntables necessarily, but he's a
consumer. Tape decks.
You know, a lot of dudes was using tape decks, when,
yes,
you know what
sir.
I'm saying? But he's
yes,
a real
sir.
Original
yes,
mixtape
sir.
DJ.
Quiet, man. Man. Love,
you
man.
You know what I'm saying,
thank
my
you.
Man?
Thank you.
Different type of nigga, man. My socks, $20, man. This ain't even YSL, though. Nigga, this Egyptian must, nigga.
Who would've knew that young snotty nose from Rocky Roads paid attention, studied and polished flows that got me shows. You don't know my name, but Poppy knows he dropping loads. You copping clothes, that's the main reason why my pocket's bulged. You wasn't from a hood, you got exposed. Flourished and got control, stand on principles and a lot of codes.
Yo, Chuck, what's the move, man? I was on my way up here to the studio, you know what I'm saying? And this brother stopped me and asked me, yo, what's up with that brother Chucky D? He's swaying nice. I said, yo, the brother don't swear he nice. He knows he's nice, you know what I'm saying? So, Chuck, I got a film. You turn me into a public
anybody
enemy,
want to shout out, say something to the people, let them know.
Man, I want to shout out, well, you. I want to shout out the whole Timberland Foundation, man. Gosh, this is funny. I'm just thinking back to everybody I want to know. Because I wasn't expecting this. You know, I want to shout out Chris G, and I'm going to tell you why. Working in the store, I work with the public, but Chris took me in the homes. And to this day, I'm out places people recognize my voice. And Chris don't know this, but it's actually helped me make a lot of moves business-wise. I have my own business. And people remember me from being on the radio. As much as they remember me working in music retail. So I want to shout out Chris. Definitely want to shout out my queen. We was best friends back when I met this knucklehead. And even when I met you, Coach, I wasn't even dating my wife then. We were just best friends. I want to shout her out because she's the one that actually helped me get my business started and encouraged me to just keep being the person that I am, man. And you know what I'm saying? Rest in peace to Max. Max was like my little brother. I don't have any younger siblings.
Yes, we tried to Max.
You know what I'm saying? So it was like, it's cool. This is crazy. I was not expecting this.
Well, you should expect it.
Like I've always told you, as far as Rochester goes,
what's up,
you
coach?
Were the sensei. You
know what I mean? Appreciate that,
the
man.
You said information, as Quan said earlier.
No doubt, no doubt.
We had to go through you to get our hip hop accreditation.
This man wasn't saying your name. You might not have been hot in the streets one time. This is when Midtown was open, when, you know, downtown was hot. So if Raj be like, hey, you heard of such and such, you heard of such and such. A lot of those cats was the next up and coming rappers. DJs. I remember the first time I ever heard of Green Lantern, it was through him.
Yes, sir.
He was hollering Green Lantern. I was like, Green Lantern? Yes, what the fuck is a Green Lantern? You know what I'm saying? So Rod was always on point with the news and what's going on in 585 and hip hop in general.
He it was important to me.
This is the Lafayette Cafe Hip Hop Music News and Reviews, and it's the last one of the year. Older Gods. December 16th, the Wu-Tang Clan lost their spiritual father, Papa Wu. Papa Wu was very vocal about Old Dirty's incarceration and the lack of support from his Wu brothers in their Wu documentary. He released his own Wu album, Visions of the 10th Chamber, in 2000.
You can check him right now at 104.3 FM, Way Yo's
Lafayette
Show.
Lafayette Cafe, and one of the cats I mentored, Cello Brown. Cello is one of the cats coming through the record store. Asked me, can you come be part of my show?
Right.
I said, no doubt. So, yes, sir. Keeping it, you know what I'm saying? Wanted me to bring that energy, that old school energy to the show. And he, in turn, I made a bunch of new friends, a bunch of young cats that I didn't think was still king. And my man, Coach, we reconnected from the mall.
Right.
Get ready, Houston, for the Swatch Watch, New York City, Fresh Festival. This Friday at the Summit, starring the world's best rappers, Run, DMC, Curtis Blow, the Fat Boys, and many more. Then it's the world's greatest breakers, the Dynamic Breakers, the Mag 4 Swatch Breakers, the Fantastic Duo, and the Uptown Express. Get your tickets now.
We got all them joints.
Right now,
that's what I'm talking about, man. That's appreciation.
Right.
It's not holding up a plant. I had it back in the days.
When I discovered artists like Larry Love and Ito and certain artists, you know what I mean, in the town, like True Star, you know what I'm saying? Certain people, it was like I stopped listening to industry. I was like, hold on, you know what I mean?
Anything else? And for the record, we started that sound, just so you know.
Of course.
Just so you know.
Of course.
We were doing this sound in 07, 04 with the Freaks and ID and
Ethel. If there was no Dublin,
we were doing that sound for anybody else.
That mix between Buffalo and Rochester coming back and forth, it wouldn't be this. You wouldn't be seeing all of that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's the connection.
That's the connection.
Know, Chris G was the first recipient of the hip hop.
Yes, sir. As he should have been.
And this is the, you know, the lineage. We just some history, talking to some historic people, and trying to lay down the foundation of upstate hip hop.
And this is brilliant.
Right, upstate, because you said the music that you were getting for us to buy. People don't realize until they leave that we were just as much abreast as hip hop as people in New York City, sometimes even more, you know?
Could I give you a quick story?
Go ahead.
Source Magazine came through Rochester. Stopped at the store. I come into work one day. Mary J. Blige is there. Red Hot Lover Tone is there. There was two dudes who worked for the Source Magazine was there. I'm not going to lie. I can't remember exactly who they were. Quan always busy. well, long story short, Red Eye Lover Tone told me, I came down here to check you because DJ Hot Day, who was a DJ for MC Poet, who used to battle Karis One back in the days, came to the store one day, said, you need to check this big dude out in Rochester. They right on Main Street. They went to Record Theater, not Record Theater in Midtown, Record Theater out in Henrietta. And they had the, Quan probably know, they had the record store in the back. Only DJs could shop back there.
On our honoree for hip hop historian, Roger Jones, formerly of Record Town. And that is an honor. That is that we haven't spoken enough about that, but that is definitely something that I know you are so deserving of. I mean, we've given you an award before, but
I appreciate
an award
it
from the hood.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? That's something different. You know what I'm
I can't believe Quan brought up my mixtapes. I thought he hated them. I'm serious.
You got mixtapes at Franklin janitor office somewhere just sitting around. I'm telling you, everybody used to listen to Roger's mixtape. You came up there to Record Town just for the mixtape, basically, most of the time.
You came up there to freestyle and chase women. That too, right?
That too.
Yes. Man, I heard about you. I'm listening to your mixtape, Quan, just mentioned. Mm-hmm. Yo, you got all the underground joints on there. I had their joint. Yeah. Red Eye Lover Tone popped up on MC Search record, Back to the Grill Again. Mm-hmm. And he heard his joint and was like, yo. He's like, so they let you play whatever? I said, they let me play whatever. Mm. That's it. So, yeah, that was a big, big nod to me, man. I couldn't believe that. Yeah. You know, the Source Magazine band parked in the back in the alley. And now here's the kicker. You ready? Mm. They came through the day before I had the day off. Manager said, you got to talk to Roger before you leave town. They came back. Now, they didn't have to.
That's respect.
They came back and chilled in there I'm literally walking through the door, and there they are. So,
legend.
To answer your question.
Legend. And homegirls, it's once again, it has been a pleasure to bring you some of the temple of hip-hop. I'm Reverend Minister MC Mix, and this is what we do here. Can I get word?
Word! Can I?
This is a Rock Attack exclusive.
Yeah, it's WBLS 107.5.
It's your boy G Nice. I gotta give a big heavyweight shout out to the newest 585 Hood Legend recipient, Rocking Raj from Record Town, Mr. Minister of Hip Hop Information for the 585. The man is a walking encyclopedia on hip hop. And not just in the 585, but internationally. Legend. Peace.
And we thank you, you know.
I thank y'all. Like I said, I was not expect this. 53 on Monday. This is a huge present right here. To honor the God.
Big shout out to my man, Silverback thank Gorilla. You see the red?
I know. Everybody call it that. Everybody call me that.
Best
great
cut in 585.
But honest to God, Mom, when they put this up, I'm going to show you this. This is another one to go on your shelf. In the crib, rest in peace to my dad. Told my dad I'll take care of my mom. I can't wait to see her face tomorrow when I show her this. And I tell her about Quan. Well, I talked about Quan. I tell her about Coach now. So she goes, who are them boys?
right.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate this.
We appreciate you. Yo, another 585 legend, Quan the Bomb. Like, share, subscribe to the page. You already know we'll be back. Watch the video. We got more coming up with my man. You already know how we do.
It is very nostalgic.
I'm 16 past the 21 club. That's a long way for running fades and keeping guns tough. Who am I kidding? One till you got your coffee, your lunch up. Make a decision, sober you up or leave you punch drunk. Pirouette on his corner and clap his goons, go and rip him. Right after you hit him, you slap the wound. Shoulda never held back right, that feel back right. Killed your cousin, shorty went on the drill that night.